Hi everybody, Ace of Hearts Fox here, and welcome to another First Seat Friday video. In today's video, I want to talk about some real-life people who inspired my persona. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, a persona can have all sorts of different meanings to different people. To some, it's a reflection on how they see themselves. For others, it's more of the culmination of all of everything that they'd like to see more of in themselves, or anything in between. In the case of my persona, Ace, however, I see him as more or less a simply amplified version of my normal personality. His most prominent trait being his positive attitude. I mean, I'm a pretty optimistic person, but my persona just believes in the good of everything. That's why in this video, I'm gonna talk about some real-life individuals that inspired positivity in both me and my persona. So let's get started! The first person I want to talk about today is Bob Ross. He hosted the TV show The Joy of Painting from 1983 to 1994. You can actually find his work everywhere from Netflix to Twitch to group classes where people can get together and paint along with his videos. Now, I've never taken a real effort to try painting, but if I did, I'd want to learn by watching Bob Ross. He puts so much emphasis on enjoying the process of painting and placing your own personal touch into your creativity. He simply enjoys it because it makes him happy, and I seriously admire that quality. Also, even if you never want to learn painting, his show is actually incredibly relaxing. Seriously, I watched every episode of Beauty is Everywhere on Netflix, and I never picked up a paintbrush. The second person I want to talk about today is Steve Irwin. He was an Australian zookeeper and conservationist who hosted a show called The Crocodile Hunter from 1996 to 2007. Basically, he traveled around and showed us all of the world's most dangerous animals. Also in 2002, he and his wife Terry started a conservation foundation built to protect injured, threatened, and endangered wildlife. What I admired most about Steve Irwin as a person, though, was his pure, unbridled enthusiasm for the things he loved. Something about how much he loved all of the work he put into improving the planet was so genuinely uplifting that it made me want to enjoy the things I loved with that amount of passion. All of the day-to-day inspiration I draw from Steve Irwin is best depicted by the crocodile hunter himself in this clip.
I don't remember doing a story with anyone as unpredictable and foolhardy and dangerous as you.
Good!
And as much fun.
Yeah, you had a bit of a good time, mate. Yeah, well, that's what life's about, isn't it? That's what life's about, mate. Just getting out there, having fun, you know, following your passion and just being enthusiastic, you know? That's the go.
Crikey.
Yeah, crikey. Have a look at this little beauty.
The last person I want to talk about today is Fred Rogers. He hosted the educational TV show Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, which first aired in 1968 and ran for 895 episodes. I actually never watched the show as a kid, but I knew who Mr. Rogers was through countless references in pop culture. The show itself was pretty simple. He might have an earnest chat with his television audience. He might visit some place like a bakery or a music store. Or he might interact with live guests, or maybe just watch a short film. One thing I really liked was his approach to wondering about the things you see around you in everyday life. Sometimes he would talk about where certain household objects come from, like where they're manufactured or how they work mechanically. I don't know, it's just really cool. But the biggest thing I admired about Mr. Rogers was his ability to believe in the good in people. He encouraged the idea that people should not just be kind to others, but they should also be kind to themselves. That they should feel a sense of worth and that everybody deserves to feel good about themselves. I think this sentiment is best summarized when he said, "Knowing that we can be loved exactly as we are gives us all the best opportunity for growing into the healthiest of people." So thanks for watching this week's Fursuit Friday video, everybody. I hope you enjoyed it. Do you have any real-life people who have been an inspiration to you or your persona? I'd love to hear about it in the comments down below. I do read every single comment, and I try to reply to as many as possible. And if you really like this video, go ahead and hit like and subscribe for new videos every week. Also, if you'd like to directly support the content that I produce on this channel, my merch store and Patreon links are in the description box below. And speaking of patrons, I want to thank these beautiful Patreon supporters for producing today's video. And I want to thank these lovely patrons for sponsoring today's video. Well, that's all I got for you guys today. Thanks again for watching, everybody. My name's Ace of Hearts Fox, and I will see you all in the next video. Pshh.